A very good afternoon to all my dear children. Okay, so before we start with the class, I would like to ask you a question. Okay, now what type of a person do you want to be? Whether you want to be a humble person or you want to be proud and arrogant? What type of person?
Humble.
Okay, can you tell something about a humble person? What is a humble person?
Kind person.
Kind person.
He is always
kind. Yes.
He has patience.
Yes. Helping. We should be helping, caring, loving.
Helping nature.
Yes.
I'm helpful.
So, all of us want to be what type of people? We want to be? Humble.
Humble person.
Yes. And what about proud and arrogant? Have you met any proud and arrogant people in your life?
What is arrogant?
Arrogant, very angry, not behaving properly.
No, ma'am.
Yes. So all of us want to be humble. So in today's lesson, what are we going to see? We are going to see some great personalities who had met a terrible fate because of their vainglorious nature. So today we are going to see all these personalities in our lesson. Okay, so we shall begin. So the name of the lesson is The Remarkable Rocket. Lesson number 6, The Remarkable Rocket. It's there in a textbook, na? Yeah, you can see now.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So the name of the lesson is The Remarkable Rocket. What is drawn here? Yes, cracker, a rocket which you all enjoy, right? When do you burst crackers? Yes. And is it good to burst crackers?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am. No. What happens if you burst crackers?
Air pollution.
Yes. So, on the whole, bursting of crackers is harmful to plants, animals, human beings. Okay. So, we shall begin with our lesson, The Remarkable Rocket. And before we begin with The Remarkable Rocket, I want to discuss the characters in this lesson. Okay, now here you can see first is the king, then king's son. These are the characters in this lesson, okay? Then princess. This princess is from Russia. Okay, she is a Russian princess. Then proto technician. Okay, now what is a proto technician? Individual trained to handle explosives. Okay, a technician is who is trained to handle explosives. Okay, now these are the crackers' names. Now, what are the crackers' names? First is Catherine Wheel, then is the Roman Candle, okay, then is a Bengal Lights, there is a Squib, Free Balloon, and then the Rocket. Okay, so these are all the characters in your lesson. Please do not talk. Okay, so these all are the characters in this lesson. Okay, so now if you are having a textbook in front of you, you take page number 52. Okay. Okay, now read this allegorical piece on the fate of an arrogant rocket. Now, what is allegorical? Okay, the word allegorical, what does it mean? Okay, so read this allegorical piece. Allegorical means a story within a story. there is one more story. Okay, a story within a story. So now you understand what is allegorical, all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so this is a read allegorical piece on a fate of an arrogant rocket. Now, fate means again destiny of this rocket. So we are going to see in this lesson. Okay, now I'm beginning with this lesson. The king's son was going to be married, so there were general rejoicing. He had waited a whole year for his bride, and at the last she had arrived. She was a Russian princess and had driven all the way from Finland in a sledge drawn by 6 reindeer. So pale was she that she drove through the streets. All the people wondered. Okay, so now it was the king's son's wedding. Okay, who was going to get married? Who was going to get married? The king's son was going to get married. Okay, the king's son was going to get married, and there was generally rejoicing. You know, all of you know what is marriage. Okay, marriage means it's a nice time where we all enjoy. Okay, there's lot of eating, there's lot of entertainment, you meet lots of people, okay, and it's a very happy time, a rejoicing time. So here, as it was the king's son's wedding, okay, was going to be, and this it was like a celebration in the kingdom. Okay, it was just like a celebration in the kingdom. He had waited a whole year for his bride. Now, what is the bride itself? Which gender? Masculine gender or feminine gender?
Feminine gender.
Okay.
Feminine.
What is the masculine gender for bride?
Groom.
Very, very good.
Groom.
Groom. Yes, good. Okay. So he was waiting for his bride for the whole year. Who was waiting? The king's son was waiting. Okay. And at last she arrived. She was a Russian princess. So whom was he waiting? He was waiting for this beautiful lady, and she was a Russian princess. Okay. And she had driven all the way from Finland. So in Russia, she was from Finland. In a sledge drawn by 6 reindeers. So she had come all the way from Finland in a sledge, and it was drawn by 6 reindeers. So pale was she that she drove through the streets. All the people wondered. Now what is her pale? Pale means light in color. It was very fair, okay? Pale. Light in color. So this princess, how was she? She was very light in color. Light in color means she was very, very, very fair, okay? And that's why the people were wondering, looking at her. She is like a white rose. They cried and they threw down flowers on her from the balconies. At the gate of the castle, the prince was waiting to receive her. So now, these people who saw her, they described her. How was she looking? She was looking like a white rose. They called her a white rose. Have you all seen a rose?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. The rose has different types of colors, no? Different colors.
Yes, ma'am. Red.
Red, pink, then orange, yellow, yeah. And she was looking like what type of rose?
Ma'am.
This princess was looking what color? She was looking like a white rose. Okay, now you have said, no? Pale, light in color. So her color was white. She was very fair. Okay. She was pale and she drove through the street, all the people wondered. And as she was passing from the street, drove through the street, okay, passing through the street, all the people were wondering. She was so beautiful. She was so fair. Okay. Now, and what happened? And they cried and they threw down flowers for her from the balconies. So they cried means they didn't cry. They shouted. Okay. And they threw down flowers from the balconies. So they were all watching when the princess was passing through their street. And they, what they did, they threw flowers on this princess from where? From their balcony. You know what is a balcony? Every house has a veranda. There's a place, no? Balcony. Yes. So they were all standing in the balcony and they threw flowers on this princess. At the gate of the castle, the princess, the prince was waiting to receive her. So the king's palace is known as a castle. Okay. And at the entrance at the gate, the prince was waiting to receive this princess. Okay. Now, can you tell me the opposite of pride?
Happy.
Happy. Okay. Or laughed? Cried is laughed. Crying. Okay. But here we are not, we are talking about pride. Were the people crying here? In, now when we say pride? No. Pride means they were shouting. In happiness. Okay. Why were they happy?
Because
the princess,
yes,
so it was a very good time, a happy time, a celebrating, a celebration was going on in the kingdom, okay, so everybody was happy, and when they saw the princess, they were very happy, okay, rejoicing, and shouting when she came, okay, let's move, okay, she had dreamy violet eyes. Sorry, not she, but he. He had dreamy violet eyes and his hair was like fine gold. So this was the princess, okay? A prince. Not the princess, but the prince. He had dreamy violet eyes. So here, author is describing how he looks. How the prince looked, okay? And what he's telling, his eyes were dreamy violet eyes and his hair was like fine gold. Okay, his hair was fine gold. When he saw her, he sank upon one knee and kissed her hand. So, as soon as this princess came, what did this prince do? He went close to her and he sank upon his knee. Means he knelt down on his knee and he kissed her hand. Okay, he kissed the princess. Now, after 3 days of preparation, the marriage was celebrated. It was a magnificent ceremony, and the bride and bridegroom walked hand in hand under a canopy of purple velvet embroidered with little pearls. Then there was a state banquet which lasted for 5 hours. The prince and princess sat at the top of a great hall and drank out of a cup of clear crystal. After the banquet, there was to be a ball. The bride and the bridegroom were to dance. The rose danced together, and the king had promised to play the flute. He played very badly, but no one had ever dared to tell him so because he was the king. Yes. Now, 3 days they had a preparation for the wedding. Okay. All of you know when there is a wedding, before that there is lots of preparation. After that wedding also, there are so many functions, small kept, okay. So, the same way, these 3 days passed, there were lots of preparation in the kingdom. The marriage was going to be there after 3 days, so there was a lot of preparation. Now, it was a magnificent ceremony. Now, here, the meaning of magnificent, extremely beautiful, okay? Magnificent. Extremely beautiful. Yes, can you give me some other words for magnificent? Now you know the meaning what it is. Extremely beautiful. Okay. Some similar words for magnificent. Anybody?
Opposite or synonym?
Similar, synonym. Synonym. Not antonym. Synonym. Nobody? Come on faster.
I want ma'am.
Give me a synonym for this word magnificent.
Glorious. Glorious.
Glorious. Somewhat close by again. Splendid. Magnificent means splendid. Spectacular. Okay. Similar words.
Wonderful.
Yes. So, now it was a magnificent ceremony. And the bride and the bridegroom walked hand in hand under a canopy. Now here, what happens now? The day had come. That is the wedding day. The bride and the bridegroom, they walked hand in hand under a canopy. Now what is canopy? An ornamental cloth. Okay. Canopy means ornamental cloth. Canopy. Yes, you have all seen for marriages how the marriage hall is decorated. Okay, so now the prince and the princess, they both walked hand in hand under a canopy of purple velvet embroidered with little pearls. So this canopy was fully embroidered. Okay, it was purple velvet embroidered with little pearls and it had all pearls on it. Then there was a state banquet. Now after the wedding there was a state banquet. Now what is banquet? Banquet. Banquet means a formal meal for many people. Formal meal for many people. When you go for weddings, you know, you go for weddings. Yes. So there's a meal served over there. And we all enjoy this meal. Right? Yes. So there was a wedding and there was a banquet. And the banquet means a formal meal for many people. Now this formal, this banquet, it lasted for 5 hours because many people of this kingdom were going to come to have their meals, okay? So it lasted for a long time, it is for 5 hours. The prince and the princess sat at the top of the great hall. So the prince and the princess, they were all sitting, not all, but the prince and the princess were sitting on top of the hall. Okay, a stage like was made for them. And they were sitting on that and drank out of a cup of clear crystal. And they were also eating and drinking. So here it is said that they drank out of a cup of clear crystal. Crystal means a transparent, highly transparent glass. And right from the top, because you cannot see. Okay, crystal. Okay, crystal means highly transparent.
And we should copy this.
Yeah, you can write in your textbook. Okay, these are the meanings of these words. You can write it. You have to write it in a textbook. Okay, so now the prince and the prince, they sat on a stage and they drank out of a cup of a clear crystal. After the banquet, there was to be a ball. Now, what is ball? What is ball? Anybody? Where there is a party. After the wedding, there was going to be a big party. Okay? Ball means party, not your cricket ball which you play. No, not a football. Okay? Here is ball means it's a big party. So, where they will drink, where they will dance and all that. Okay, so the bride and the bridegroom were to dance the rose dance together. So in this ball, the bride and the bridegroom, okay, that is the bride and the bridegroom were to dance the rose dance together, and the king had promised to play the flute. So in this ball, the bride and the bridegroom were going to dance the rose dance, and the king, what was he going to do? He was going to play the flute. But this king was not a perfect player. He didn't play the flute very nicely, okay? So what happened? He played very badly. But no one had ever dared to tell so why? Because he was a king. So nobody dared to tell that he is playing so badly, okay? The last item of the program was a grand display of fireworks to be let out exactly at midnight. So in there was a ball. First thing, the celebration wedding, the wedding took place. After the wedding, what was there? There was meal for all the people. After the meal, what was there? That went on for 5 hours. Okay. After that, what was there?
Rose dance.
Okay, ball. They had a ball. The prince and the princess were going to have a rose dance. And what was the king going to do? What was the king? Yes, he was going to play the flute. Okay, so the king was not good at playing flute, but nobody dared to tell the king. Okay, let's move ahead. The last item of the program was a grand display of fireworks. So now the last part of this program was a display of fireworks. Okay, to be let off exactly at midnight. Now, what is midnight? Midnight is
twelve o'clock.
When? Afternoon? Night? Okay, so it was in the night. Okay. The little princess had never seen fireworks in her life. Mute your system. Okay. The little princess had never seen a firework in her life. So the king had given orders that the royal prototechnician should be attending on the day of her marriage. So now what happened? This princess was getting married to the king's son. She had never seen what a fireworks. Okay, and that is the reason why the king wanted to have this fireworks. Okay, and that's the reason he had ordered that a royal prototechnician should be attending on the day of the marriage. Okay, so what are fireworks like? She asked the prince. So this is what a question she put. First of all, she didn't know what are fireworks. So she wanted to know what are fireworks, and that's the reason she asked the prince. Okay. Okay. One morning, as she was walking on the terrace. So as she was walking on the terrace, she asked the prince, what are fireworks? But what happens? They are like the Aurora Borealis, said the king, who always answered questions that are addressed to other people only much more natural. I prefer them to stars myself. As you always know when they are going to appear, and they are as delightful as my own flute playing. So this princess, now when she answers the prince, what is this crackers or the fireworks, okay? But the answer was not given by the prince. Who answered her question? It was answered by the king, okay? And this king had the habit, you can say he had a habit of always answering the question that were addressed to other people. Now this question was asked by the prince to the by the princess to the prince, but the answer was given by the king. Okay, and now before I would like to tell you actually what are aurora borealis. Okay, what they are. So aurora borealis are natural electrical phenomenon characterized by the appearance of streaked or reddish or green light in the sky, especially near the northern or southern magnetic poles. The effect is caused by the interaction of charged particles from the sun with atom and upper atmosphere. In northern and southern region, it is respectively called aurora borealis. So this is what aurora borealis are, and they are like the king says, like aurora borealis. Okay, and they are very natural. They prefer them as to stars myself. So the king says that I prefer them like they are stars, and he says you always know they are going to appear as they are delightful as my own flute playing. So he says they are very delightful, it means they are very nice. Okay, and he compares those aurora borealis to his flute playing. So he feels that how he feels very happy, very nice to play this flute. In the same way, he likes to see this aurora borealis. Okay, the fireworks. Okay, dear children, we shall continue in our next class the remaining